Anthony Brown is trying to make history this November. If elected, the Democratic gubernatorial candidate would become the first black governor in Maryland, as well as the first lieutenant governor to make the move up.
I'm looking for a change, so I'm hoping that he can present that change.
But in a state where Democrats outnumber Republicans by more than 2-1, Brown is finding himself in a much tighter race than many had predicted.
On a personal level, Anthony Brown is not a real exciting guy.
There's always the famous, do I want to have a beer with this guy test, and I don't think either of them passes it.
It's a tough year for Democrats.
Brown spent 30 years in the military and served 2 terms in the Maryland House of Delegates representing Prince George's County before becoming lieutenant governor under Martin O'Malley. But some say his 2 terms in the O'Malley-Brown administration may be hurting his chances.
It was very clear from the start that they had decided that what the O'Malley-Brown administration was popular enough that he and Ken Ullman were not going to distance themselves.
There's a certain degree of voter fatigue about Governor O'Malley.
Brown declined to speak on camera with us. He did agree to a telephone interview, explaining how his platform differs from O'Malley's.
We're different people. Ken Ullman and I are going to declare as our first strategic priority is going to be to position Maryland's business climate as number one in the country.
But according to some political observers, the strength of Brown's platform is that he's not a Republican.
He really just needs to keep hitting home over and over again that Hogan is a Republican.
Which means bringing up issues like gun control and women's rights in a series of political ads attacking Hogan.
Larry Hogan's dangerous Republican agenda, the wrong direction for Maryland.
We think it's important that voters hear about all issues, not just the issues that certain candidates are more comfortable with.
But even having the advantage of being a Democrat in a blue state might not be enough for Brown. Reinforcements have been called onto the campaign trail. Names like Bill and Hillary Clinton, and even Barack Obama.
He's still quite popular with some Democratic voters, and particularly African-American voters. And this is a group that Anthony Brown needs to really excite.
There's been speculation for a long time that Anthony Brown is, quote, not black enough.
But Brown still has his supporters.
Anthony Brown has been right by Governor O'Malley's side, and I think he's the better of the two candidates to build on O'Malley's achievements and to continue to make this a better Maryland for all Marylanders.
I believe that he can make a change in the state of Maryland.
Dennis Ting, reporting for CNS-TV.